Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. This morning, SpaceX successfully launched their 68th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 89. The booster which launched this mission, B1073, then landed successfully for the 16th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas. This week and going into next, we can hopefully expect to see a couple more missions to launch. The first of these, the Starlink 93 mission, is currently scheduled for Sunday 7th at 3:33 a.m. UTC or Saturday 6th at 11:33 p.m. EST. Then the following day, we can hopefully expect to see a customer mission launch. The TurkSat 6A mission is currently scheduled for Monday 8th at 9:20 p.m. UTC or 5:20 p.m. EST. SpaceX posted some information about Falcon missions so far this year. They said Falcon launched 67 missions in the first 6 months of 2024, delivering nearly 900 metric tons to orbit so far this year. There was an article posted with SpaceX getting more launches on Falcon 9. It says Emirati satellite operator Yarsat has selected SpaceX to launch a pair of geostationary communications satellites that are part of a $1.1 billion program. Yarsat announced July 1st that it chose SpaceX to launch its Al-Yar-4 and Al-Yar-5 satellites in 2027 and 2028 respectively on Falcon 9 rockets. There was an article from NASA about yet another payload that SpaceX has been selected to launch. It says NASA has selected SpaceX to provide launch services for the COSI mission. The firm fixed price contract has a value of approximately $69 million, which includes launch services and other mission related costs. Heading to Boca Chica, the final vertical GSE tank was removed for scrapping. This potential structural test stand was spotted at Starbase. Work has been continuing on the base of the second orbital launch tower. Outfitting for the Launch Tower 2 sections that will soon be stacked has been continuing. Starship Gazer posted a picture with some information about the second launch tower. It says Starbase Launch Tower 2 Module 1 has rolled out to begin stacking Tower 2. I wanted to share a post with some information from Elon Musk about a super heavy landing view that we may get on the mission. In reference to a view from the chopsticks of super heavy landing, someone posted asking if we can see that with the next Starship launch. Musk responded to this and said, okay. There was a video of an engineer removing tiles from a Starship. Somebody posted saying, kinda surprised no one at SpaceX has cobbled together some kind of heat shield tile extractor tool. Musk responded and said, you're right, we're working on simple tooling to make this fast and repeatable. The work on Starship 30's new heat shield tile system is continuing. After chopstick catch testing, the B14.1 test tank was moved back to the production site. After an electrical fire during testing, Starship 31 was repaired and has been rolled to Massey's for more testing. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.